Welcome.
Guess what time it is?
It's time for Kids Church.
We are really glad you've joined us today.
So get ready.
Because we're going to laugh and learn and worship.
And pray and grow and connect.
If you are in the area, we want to invite you to come and join us in person.
We would love to see you.
And hear your voices when you worship.
And run around the playground playing tag with you.
And give you a high five in the check-in tent.
And hear your something good.
And listen to all the ways you are learning about Jesus and how much he loves you.
But until we see you in person, we are happy to get to connect here online.
That's right. Welcome to Kids Church.
Yo, 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 what is up, everybody? Welcome, Casey's family. Hey, guys, I'm so glad you're here. All right, so what's about to happen is I'm gonna try like the t-shirt contest or the t-shirt challenge. I don't know if there's an actual name for it. What's gonna happen is I'm gonna give myself 1 minute to put on as many t-shirts as I possibly can. As you guys see, I got, you know, my t-shirts there, the swag and stuff like that. So we're gonna see what happens in a minute. I did a little bit of research online. I think the Guinness World Record is 26 t-shirts in a minute. You know, I don't know, maybe that's doable. I mean, let's see. Are you guys ready? All right, let's do it. I'm gonna hit the timer. Timer, please. I got you up here. All right, cool. All right, here we go.
The game begins in 3,
Mamba mentality.
2, 1.
Oh, your boy Sonic over here, bro. We got 3. Cheer for me at home. I need to hear y'all. Oh, there we go. Woo! Oh, that one's dirty. I didn't wash that one. That's my part.
Move, you stay!
Woo! Come on, one more. Woo! Okay. How I look?
I am beautiful, no matter what they say.
It's definitely a no for me, dog.
All right, I actually don't even know how many shirts I have on. All right, we're gonna count real quick. Should we count? So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, all right, wow, 26. All right, I don't know how they did 26. I got 7 in a minute. I feel like I did okay.
No, all right.
So guys, I had to take the headband off, it was getting in the way. And I got a new game plan. Like I said, I'm trying to get 11 within a minute, that's my new goal. And I got like the shirts, you know, kind of set up like this. I feel like it's gonna help me out to get to my goal. All right, let's get it.
In 3, 2,
just the 1.
1.
Oh yeah! Oh yeah, oh. Come on y'all, cheer for me. Uh-huh. Ooh, I'm already getting hot. All right. Oh, I messed this one up. Oh, come on.
Bruh.
Oh, I'll put it on backwards.
What are you doing?
Oh, come on. Come on, 12. It's a musty one. It smells bad. It's all right. No! Oh! Hey, I look funny. Okay, so how many were left? 1, 2, 3. Oh man, that means I was only able to get 9 this time. You guys do the challenge at home. Send it to here. Send it here. Here. At Kids Church. I would love to see you guys try it. If anything, I would love to see you guys look like this. Because this is funny. Alright? Now you guys can go enjoy the rest of the service. Alright? Peace. Woo!
What's up, guys? One of my favorite things that we get to do here at Kids Church is worship. And there are so many ways to worship God. I love that we get to sing and dance to some amazing songs to honor God. But worship isn't just about singing and dancing. It's about honoring God with everything that we do. And worship is the way that we get to respond to God by telling Him and showing Him how much we love Him. Right now, one of the ways that we're going to get to worship God is by giving Him our offering. By giving God our offering, we are telling Him that we love Him and acknowledge that everything we have comes from Him. All right, while we start singing, go ahead and grab your offering and put it in your worship jar. I'm so proud of you and each of you for worshiping God in this way. Are you guys ready? Let's worship. Come on, stand on up.
Hi, everyone. I'm so glad that you've joined us again for the Kids Church Family Experience. It has been so much fun the past few weeks as we've been discovering how God made us to be creative. Creativity is imagining what you could do because you're made in God's image. There are so many ways to be creative, but for our game today, we're focusing on one aspect of creativity, music. Let's play Mystery Tune. I'm going to draw a piece of paper from this bowl. This will tell me which song to play on my kazoo. I'm going to have 10 seconds to play the song on the kazoo and see if you can guess what song it is. You ready? Okay, let me get my first song. Got it. Here we go. That was 10 seconds. You want to try? See if you know what it was? What do you think? Yes! Old MacDonald. Very good. You want to do another one? Okay, here we go. One more piece of paper. All right. You ready? Song number two. Did you know what song that one was? I bet you figured it out. Baby Shark. All right, let's do one more. Which one? I'm gonna mix them up. All right, here we go. Song number three. Ready? Here we go. Yes, what do you think? What do you think? A little louder? Yes, Let It Go. Nice job, you guys. I gotta say, well, I'm not sure that the kazoo is my favorite instrument. I do love music, and I love the way that it gives us a chance to be creative. How about you guys? Do any of you play an instrument? What about, do you like to sing? Have you ever been creative and made up a song? I think that one of the things that I really love about creativity is that things don't always end up the way that you thought that they would when they started. You may have an idea in the beginning, but your creativity may lead you in a totally different direction than what you had been planning at first. You can end up with a really unexpected outcome. Well, speaking of things being unexpected, that's one of the things that I love about God. Because of his wisdom and his power and his goodness, he is so often working in unexpected ways. The story that we're going to take a look at today is a fantastic example of that. Today we're going to find out about a woman in the Bible named Esther and how God worked through her in a completely unexpected way. Let's take a look.
Slapstick Theater. Esther's Request to the King. This is Esther, who was a Jewish orphan who lived in Persia during the reign of King Xerxes. Esther was adopted by her relative, Mordecai, who worked in the palace of the king. Once, Mordecai had even saved the king's life.
Yep.
Esther became the queen of Persia, but no one knew she was a Jew because Mordecai told her to keep it a secret. This is Haman. Who was the second most powerful man in Persia. Haman hated Mordecai because Mordecai wouldn't bow down to him. So Haman convinced King Xerxes to make a decree to kill all Mordecai's people, the Jews. When Mordecai learned about this, he was very upset, as were all the Jews in Persia. When Queen Esther's servants came and told her about how upset Mordecai was, she sent one of her servants, Hatak, to go to Mordecai and find out what was troubling him. So Hatak went out to Mordecai, and Mordecai told him of the plan to kill God's people. Mordecai said that he wanted Esther to go to the king to ask for him to save the Jews. Esther knew that anyone who went to the king without being called could be put to death. But Mordecai reminded Esther that she may have been made queen for such a time as this. So Esther asked for the Jews to pray for her and fast for 3 days. Then Esther put on her royal robes and went before the king. When the king saw Esther, he was happy to see her and asked, "What do you want, Queen Esther? I will give it to you, even if it's half the kingdom." So Esther asked the king if he and Haman would come to a banquet that she had prepared for them, and the king agreed. Esther held a banquet and then asked the king and Haman to come to a second banquet the next night. That night, the king was reminded of how Mordecai had once saved his life. King Xerxes decided that he must honor Mordecai and that Haman would help. Huh? Then, at the second banquet, Esther told the king about the plot against her people. The king was angry and asked, "Who would do such a thing?" Esther said it was Haman, and the king ordered Haman to be killed on that very night.
Uh-oh.
But the decree to kill all the Jews was still in place, and the Jews were still in danger. So Mordecai asked the king to issue a new decree so that the Jews could defend themselves. The king did, and the Jews defeated all their enemies. God's people were saved and celebrated their great victory.
God had a big purpose in mind for Esther. I love what Mordecai wrote in that letter. What did it say? Let's read it together. It's possible that you became queen for a time just like this. Esther 4:14. Just like God had an important purpose for Esther, he had the most amazing purpose and plan when he sent his son, Jesus. He sent Jesus to save the world. Because Jesus came to be our Savior, we can have a relationship with God that will last forever. God created each one of you for a purpose. Say it with me as you point to someone else in the room with you right now. God created you for a purpose. Now, you might wonder exactly what your purpose is. The truth is that God's purpose for you is not just one thing. It may be something big and exciting that God does through you at one time, or maybe over lots and lots of years. Sometimes it's just the day-to-day normal things that fill up your regular day. God's purpose for you is to do those things using the unique gifts that he has given you. What is likely true is that throughout your life, it's going to be a bit of both. I want to encourage you to pay attention to the gifts God gave you. And when you get a chance to use them, do it. Now, you might be wondering right now, Becca, what are my gifts? How has God uniquely made me? How do I know what those things are? Well, there are a few things that I would recommend you doing to start exploring that. The first thing you can do is you can think about the things that excite you or make you happy or bring you joy when you're doing them. Chances are what comes to mind is a unique gift that God has created you with. Or maybe you can think about the things that you see and notice that make you sad. Ways that you see the world not looking like you know God created it to look. People not being treated with kindness and with love. People not having enough of the things that they need. It's likely that while we should all definitely care about those things, God may have created you with a heart that's especially sensitive and caring about those things, and his purpose for you might be to do something to make those things better. Maybe you have the skills and ideas to help solve a problem that you see. Thinking about those things is a really great place to start. And something else that might help is talking to a parent or somebody else who really knows you and asking them, what do they see in you? It's going to look different for every person. That's the amazingly beautiful thing about the way that God creates each one of us. With me, for example, I believe that God has given me a gift in the area of music. Ever since I was little, I've loved music and singing and playing instruments. And so at a young age, I started working hard and practicing to get better at the gift that I believe God had given me. I didn't know yet what his purpose for my life was or how he was going to use that part of me, but I wanted to work hard and be ready when it was clear. Now that I'm older, I can look back and I can see that God had more than one purpose in placing that gift in me. One of his purposes was for me to teach lessons and help other people to learn and grow in their gifts. One of his purposes was for me to work with kids and teenagers to create plays that would bring joy and fun and laughter to families in the community. One of his purposes was for me to use my gift in the church to encourage my brothers and sisters in Jesus, to remind them of the things that are true about God, and to lead them in worshiping him. It hasn't just been one thing. And my guess is that he may have even more opportunities for me in the future to continue to live out his purpose for my life within this gift. The truth is, there are so many ways you can live out God's purpose for your life. Your life is going to be filled with them. One of the things that I love most about working at Kids Church is getting to see those lights that God has put inside each of you start to really shine. I love getting to see you begin to grow in your gifts in the unique way that God has created you to be in this world. In just a minute after I pray, I encourage you, take some time and dig a little deeper into what we've been talking about today with your family. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for not only creating each one of us, but also creating us for a purpose. It feels so good to know that we can play a part in your good plan. Thank you for the story of Esther and that it shows us that you have a plan and a purpose for each of us. We know, God, that we can trust you no matter what. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for creating us uniquely. Thank you for having a plan for us. We love you. We trust you. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Enjoy your time with your family. See you soon.